Oh, also, Natalie, looking absolutely stunning. The reasons why, everyone, is because of that man in the middle of the table.
Shower, and I call lads on holiday, come up after them, rock out with your cock out.
The dummy goes into the bathroom. Showers, comes out. I went to take a second look, so I thought Ron Jeremy had just walked back into the room. I've never put on a pair of boxer shorts so quickly in my entire life. So from then onwards, he was known as Darren the Tripod Person. Holiday was also the making of mine and Darren's relationship. It's where he went from being a friend to a brother. And like all brothers, I discovered that we weren't actually that dissimilar. And between us, we had the finest moves the Turkish vodka could buy at the moment. A few of Darren's favourites. The skipping rope. We had the seatbelt, the mowing of the lawn, and the pneumatic drill. So whilst trying to impress the ladies with these fire moves, if they didn't work, I'd always get up the tap on the shoulder. I knew exactly what was about to commence. The gold spring. Me being the idol wingman, I never hesitated to step up and do what a best man does best, supporting a brother in need. So now, I think we should do that this time. So, my friend, up you down. And, using my show, thank you. So what I want you to do is I want you to impress your new wife. And I want you to go and mow her lawn. But before you mow her lawn, my friend, you put on that seatbelt. And then, and only then, you give her the best drill you've ever given. Do you understand? Do you understand what you're going to do? Skip a rope. Off we go. Yeah. Yeah. Can I do it all, please, Adam? Seatbelt. Now you get that drill out, my friend. I've got time to say, come on. As you can imagine, the 23-year-old lads, we quickly renamed that to Avenue. And during the first few months of living with her, I soon realised this wasn't the typical lifestyle I'd signed up for. A few of Darren's beauty habits. The teeth whitening kit he used most nights. Secondly, asking me to Saint-Tropez back, another area that he couldn't reach. The continual face marks. I could go on forever. But these unusual traits are manliness continued. I play five side every Wednesday. Our other housemate went to rugby training. Darren went off to theatre rehearsal. But throughout this period, somehow he was always a massive hit with the ladies. I won't go into too much detail, but the walls of this house were pretty much paper thin, and I was sandwiched in between a rugby lad and his apparent theatre stuff. So in-club soon became part of my nightly sleeping routine. Dan was the most fussiest man when it came out to settling down or having any form of relationship. He was the real-life charmer from Friends. And just a few of his excuses. Number one, she has back hair. Number two, a hairy top lip. Why are you dating anyone with a hairy top lip in the first place? Number three, her boobs are too big. Anything more than a handful's away, say, mate. So the day comes. He calls me up and asks him to meet me for a drink. Very unexpectedly, I met Darren. And he informs me that he's going to ask Natalie to marry him and would like me to be the best man. Or should I say, maid of honour? As to be fair, that's what it felt like, mate.
asking me to go ring shopping. Just because I got married before you doesn't make me a ring expert. I don't even like shopping for my wife, let alone your wife. So we spent the whole day trolling Hattie Gardens until we found the one. Anyway, thinking that was going to be my best man's duties over until the stag, the next step was the engagement itself. Operation Bloody Sparkle. I had to get to bed early, light the balloons, decorate the tables with the candles, tick everyone off the guest list, hand out champagne, the long list continued, yada yada yada. So after this, I decided to do some research into a best man's duties. Number one, provide moral support for that build-up. Check. Number two, try to tux. Check. Number three, organise a stag. Check. Number four, attend the rehearsal. Check. And I found out where Darren's got his best man's duties from. www.nattywilkinsonsbestmansduties.com. It all now makes sense. So the stag, the three-man stag. Good day, hand up. And Davila over there. Barcelona was the chosen destination. A vibrant party city. Lots of clubs and bars. A very cool, trendy place, I was told. Darren, on the other hand, didn't get this information. So the first night on the stag, we thought we'd go big. And when stags say they're going big, we're going big, guys. So we thought casual dress wasn't appropriate. Nor was smart cash. Nor was smart. So we decided to go smart, smart. Or in Darren's case, safari park smart. It was quite clear Natalie had packed a suitcase. Ron Jeremy had left the room and David Attenborough had taken over. It wasn't even like this was a stag where we were going to dress him up in some hideous ghastly costume. He'd taken it on himself to dress him up in his own fancy dress. Anyway, with the abuse he received over the next 5 minutes, he was changed and ready to go in a matter of seconds. Much like Superman. Talk to Superman. An action hero. Does anyone know Darren is Elizabeth Hurley's bodyguard? Although this is probably one of the most memorable moments of the stag, I sat there with Dave, crying with laughter. It was at that point I thought to myself how ready Darren was for married life. How he turned into this downright figure overnight without even knowing. Just a good stand-up guy. Somebody who father would mind their daughter bringing home. I genuinely mean this, though. You are the most loyal friend anyone could ever wish for. I could call you up at any given moment, and you'd be there. You're a caring, loving, sensitive little soul at times, and I can assure Natalie's parents here today that Natalie is in safe hands. We've been through a lot together, we've seen a lot together, and as I stand beside you, watching you make a plunge, I could be more happy and sure that what you're about to do was the right thing, and marrying the gorgeous, amazing woman in Natalie Percival. So the bride and groom, ladies and gentlemen. Just one more thing. I know it's not a piece now, sorry. I know it's the most traditional thing to do to read out a soft poem at the end of a speech. But I thought this was rather fitting to see what a fantastic day has been so far. The perfect groom loves children, but he will raise them by your side. He'll be a good father and a husband to his bride. The perfect groom is sweet, writing poetry in your name. He's best friends with your mother, and he kisses away your pain. He'll never make you cry or hurt you in any way. And if this poem is down to be true, then Darren, you really are gay.